Hey guys, just a quick message before this video starts. Just want to give a quick shout out to the Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. It is a book absolutely rammed with information regarding anything HGV related. Don't care whether you're new in the industry, whether you've been in the industry for 5 years like myself, or whether you are a veteran in the HGV world and you've done more miles in reverse than I've done forward, there is something in this book that will benefit you, I absolutely promise you. We're talking taco rules and regulations, how to strap a load, how to hitch up to a trailer, and also how to even get your HGV license in the first place. Everything that you need to know is in this book. Promise you, you won't regret it. Link is in the description down below if you are interested. The Essential New Truckers Handbook by Malcolm Green. Anyway, enjoy the video. Everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Luke. Thank you very much for watching. Do appreciate it. How you doing? You all right? You good? Right now we are in Caen. We're getting loaded with what they call PET, which is like recycled plastic squashed into squared bales. It's going onto the back of the trailer, as you can see there. We get a full load on, front to back, bottom to top. That's it. Bottom to top. Fully loaded. It doesn't actually weigh that much. We get weighed on the way out. I'll let you know how much we weigh. But it's a full load in terms of like volume of the vehicle. We strap it up with the internals because it is so light, so we can get away with just using the internals going down the whole length of the trailer. So we'll do that in a minute when we're allowed out. At the moment we're not allowed out because obviously he's loading us, so we've got to stay in the truck. But yeah, this is going to Scoundersdale. This is a little bit different, this video. Because two things really. One, I'm starting now, late in the afternoon, and this is being delivered first thing in the morning, whereas I would normally just start tomorrow morning. And secondly, because this is going to be, I don't want to say first, because I think I've done it before, but this video is going to be in 4K, true 4K. My last video was 4K, but it was actually upscaled from 2.7K if you want to get technical. But normally, I record in 2.7K and downscale to full HD, 1080p. I know some people probably won't get that, but either way, this vlog is 4K. So you basically can see my beautiful face in 4K resolution. Oh, talking off my face. I've been getting a few comments recently about my eye. It looks like a black eye. Oh, hang on. I'll talk about this in a sec. I've got to go. Okay, right. I'm back in the truck. Just had to put some straps on. So, my eye. So I often get told I look tired, or I get told it looks like you've got a black eye, and yeah. Just recently it's been happening quite a lot, and there's nothing I've really spoken about before in the past, but I will now. So I basically got an eye condition, and if I get closer, like you can see, I've got long eyelashes. You see this eye here, it's fine, but this eye, my eyelashes are actually in my eye. They touch my pupil now, or iris, whatever you want to call it. Now the problem with that is it makes my eye very itchy, and what I do is I rub it an awful lot during the day, which is why I get the bruising around my eye. And it's a vicious circle because I got eyelashes in my eye, which makes me itch, which then makes me rub my eye, which then damages the eyelashes even more, which then itches even more. So it's like a vicious circle. Now I got eye drops that I'm supposed to put in every night to try and repair the iris, and every now and then my girlfriend uses like eyelash curlers or something, and she tries to get the eyelash out a little bit on this eye, because yeah, as you can see, it's like in my eye compared to the other one. They're long on both sides, but that side in particular is the one that's really bad. So but yeah, every time I go get my eyes tested, the person doing the eye test, they and it's a different person each time, but they always go, oh, aren't your eyelashes lovely, oh, you got lovely eyelashes. And I'm like, it's actually annoying. Like, I don't want long eyelashes, but I do. But yeah, that's why my eye always looks like it's slightly bruised or looks like I'm slightly tired. It's because I'm rubbing my eye, bruising myself. I had my eyebrow pierced up here. I don't know if you can tell. I used to have it, my eyebrow pierced, and I got a black eye from that as well when I was younger. But yeah, anyway, he's nearly finished loading me now. A full load of PET. Don't know why they call it PET. Plastic something. Plastic economical. No idea. Someone tell me what pet means, other than dog and cats. Right, when he's finished loading me, we'll crack on outside. We'll do the rest of the load up via internals. And then we're going to get out of here because it's 3:10 now. So, yeah, we should be back in the yard before 4:00. Oh, was that him beeping or someone else? Anyway, see you in a bit.
Okay, here we are. This is the load. So each bale's got an internal strap going around it. And then two on that one, two on that one. And then it's crisscrossed on the back the best I can, with a couple going downwards as well. Yeah, there we go. That's going to have to do. Like I said, they're all strapped up. I don't think they're going to go anywhere. Happy days.
Okay, and then it's all done up with the curtains either side. We got 24 ratchets either side. So 48 ratchets in total across the whole length of the trailer, meaning that everything is going to stay nice and secure in the trailer. Right, we're all good to go. Okay, first weighbridge of the video. We want a few more of these, I reckon, in this video. Let's get some paperwork. Thank you. Cheers, mate. See you later.
Okie dokie.
Right, so we are now fully loaded. What was the weight? I said about the weight, didn't I? There's a vehicle behind me, so I don't want to stop and interrupt him. I need to stop to read this. We weigh a gross weight of 25 ton, the net is 10. Yes, we've got 10 tons of plastic. 10 tons of plastic. Yeah, so it's a little bit awkward because they haven't loaded it all the way to the back. Now I did say, are you not gonna put more on? He said no, because actually you've got one row more than you should have anyway. I was like, okay. So yeah, I've had to crisscross on the back. But because it's three individual bales, when you crisscross, it doesn't really cover like the middle one and the top one. It only really covers a little bit of the top and then mostly the middle. So even though I've crisscrossed it and the middle's secure, the top one isn't, which is why I put straps on the back, sort of thrown it around the back a little bit, so it's in front of the top, then strap the cross ones and then strap the ones going down, so the tops are protected as well. So in my opinion, the load is not going to move. If it does move, it'll only go back slightly, but it's not going to actually tip over. So yes, right, let's squeeze past him. Thank you very much. So yeah, it's not going to fall off the trailer at all, because we've got the curtains as well as a second safety measure, so to speak. So all good in the hood. Right, anyway, I'm going to go back to the yard now, park up for the night, and I will see you in the morning. It won't be first thing in the morning because it's going to be 4:00 when I start, and I'm a little bit grumpy in the mornings. So I'll probably see you when we're close to Scammersdale, around sort of 8:00 ish. So yeah, see you in the morning. Morning, welcome back. You join me as we're literally just come off the motorway. We're gonna head into Skelmersdale. We're literally only a mile away, so we're just around the corner.
We're booked in for between 7 and 8 is when we're booked in, and it's actually 7:30 right now. So we're smack bang in the middle, which is good. That was the time I was aiming for, so happy days. We won't be in straight away. This place is a little bit weird. It's hard to explain. When we get there, you'll see in a minute, when we get there, you can't just park in front of the gates. You kind of got to go around, like a roundabout sort of thing, park up and walk over to see them. And that's assuming you can park up. So yeah, that's what you got to do. And then it's quite tight in there, so you got to go on in, go on the weighbridge, and then they unload you, and then you reverse back out over the weighbridge. Because there's no room to turn around or anything like that. So it is a little bit tight in there. Hang on, I've said it again, a little bit tight, it's my favourite saying. But yeah, no, we're just around the corner. I don't know what I'm going to do later yet. I still haven't had a message telling me what I'm doing after this. But I'll find out sooner or later. I'm going to be here for the very least an hour, maybe two. Because it's 7:30 now. I don't think I'm going to be out much before 9 o'clock, to be honest. But you never know. You never know. We might be. You're going left. So yeah, Skelmersdale. I've been in this industrial estate a few times, different areas. I've been to Stackwright a few times when I was doing port cabins. That was somewhere around here. Yeah, we're just going to take a right-hand turn here. The company we're going to is called, I think it's called Viridor. They're quite strict. I'm wearing shorts at the moment, so I'm going to have to put my waterproof trousers on, because they won't let me in wearing shorts. I know that for a fact. Let's see if there's anyone else here or not. Is there any more trucks lined up? No, there's no trucks lined up. That's good. So yeah, the place is there where that Swain lorry is. That's where we got to go. But we can't... There's a lorry already in there. Hawkins. But we can't park here, so we've got to go right round. And then pretty much park just over there, facing this way again. And then walk over, give them a reference number and all that, and then they get me in when they can. Let's go around here. Just gonna let that lorry know that I am parking up. Go around the left hand side of me. There we go. So yeah, we're just going to walk on over now, give them a reference number, and go from there really. We've just done 3 hours of driving to get here. 3 straight hours. Ugh, so it'd be good now to get out and stretch my legs. Right, see you in a bit. Okay, so the truck that was in there is just about to pass me now. There he goes. That's the truck that was in there. So hopefully they call me in a minute. Time is getting on. Yeah, it's 8:50 nearly. Wow, I thought I would have been out of here by now. Right, we're fine. Finally getting out of here. So we turned up at 7:30. It's now 10:10 almost by the time we get out of here. Need to open up the other gate, mate. You need to open up the other gate, mate. I'm not getting out unless you open up the other gate. Wait. The guard's quite tight, so we've got to reverse out of one end. Well, we've got to reverse out of the entrance and then drive out of the exit and do a spinny. Okay, clear that way, clear that way. Excellent. Right, so we've now got to go and get some bricks from H&H. I've not got my seatbelt on yet because I'm stopping again in a second. Illegal. You're allowed to do that as an HGV driver. You're allowed to not wear a seatbelt if you're stopping within a certain amount of distance. Don't quote me on that distance. I think it's 50 yards or something. Well, you've left that a bit tight, mate. I have to rub the stuff there because you're there. Curbs. Thank you. Right, yeah, so we're just stopping here because I just want to take these orange trousers off. I've got to put them back on again in a sec when I get to my next destination. But they're sort of very sticky when you get sticky underneath. So, just need to take my shoes off, jump over here, take the trousers off. Because, yeah, you're not allowed to wear shorts at the place I'm going to next either. So, I mean, I do have jeans in my side locker. Trousers are falling down then. Yeah, I do have jeans in my side locker as well. So I could just put them on. But I'll just continue wearing these shorts for now and put them back on when I need to. Take my hoodie off. Hoodie off, high vis off, get a bit more comfortable. That sun's out, so again, need to have some specs on. Hoods off. Indicator on. Let's go. So yeah, we are now empty. We've got to go to H&H now and get a load of blocks, breeze blocks, I'm assuming. And that's got to go down sort of Bournemouth area for tomorrow. So it's a long old drive down to Bournemouth from where we've got to get loaded. A good sort of 4 or 5 hour drive. We'll find out when we get there, because I put the postcode in just to see. But we're going back to the yard tonight, staying in the yard tonight, and then it'll get dropped off tomorrow morning. Because from the yard, it takes about 2.5 hours to get there. And we've pretty much got to pass our yard to get there anyway, so that's the plan. So we're gonna get going. It's a 2 hour drive to our destination when we've got to get loaded, so we won't be there until about 12 o'clock, just gone. Yeah, just gone 12. Yeah, no, it's a shame we were there for so long. It's not that I'm in a rush or anything. Not in a rush at all, I just don't like sitting around. And it's one of those places where you can't stay in your cab either. So I'm there outside. So just a little bit annoying, really, more than anything. It'd be fine if I was sat in the cab. Right, anyway, let's get going. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, we are nearly here. Go over the bump. There's a lane coming up. It takes you to Great Heck. Not that one, another one. And you've got to go through Great Heck to get to Pollington, which is where we're getting loaded. Now, I saw a sign. I've only been here twice before. Maybe three times. Because there's two different places. You've got H&H and you've also got Kelk. And I've been to each of those places. Like, both times you've got to go the same way, basically. But there's a sign saying no HGVs. So the first time I come here, I went past the turn-in. I went in another way. The second time I come here, I did the same, but I did see a truck go down that way. This is the third time I'm coming this way. I'm going down that lane because it's quicker. I just seen a sign back there that said no HGVs via to Pollington via Heck Lane, which is exactly the roads I'm using. But it says in small print, well, not small print, but it says at the bottom between 11 p.m. and 6:30 a.m.
Admit that.
Yeah, so 11 p.m. to 6:30 a.m. is when you're not allowed to go down the lane. So I'm going down the lane. It's this lane here coming up. There's another sign there, look, that blue sign. No HGVs, access, Pollington, via Greyfield, 11 p.m. to 6:30 a.m. So between 6:30 a.m. and 11 p.m. you can, and it's 12 p.m. so I can. Yeah, you'll see a lot of Keedwell trucks around here. Loading up with the bricks. Stobart biomass. There'll be a lot of walking floors in there. Right, yeah, so this place, I've got to wear trousers, so I'll jump out and I'll put those trousers on. Also, the last time I come here, I had to pay for a chin strap. Why are you slowing down? I need to go exactly where you are. Gate 2. Don't be busy. Yeah, it's a little bit busy. So we're nearly loaded. One side is completely done, and he's just doing the other side now, the side I'm on. I'm not quite sure where he's gone, but I can do the first two rows up here because they're all on. Just got to wait for the rest of them to be put on before I do them. So yeah, each one of these rows is going to be strapped up. With the one on the top, on the front, with two straps probably, just to be safe. And we're also going to tidy up all our straps as well, so they're nice and tidy, just for you, Andy. Right, let's get the rest of these on. See you in a bit. Okay, right, we're strapped up. Just done this curtain forward. I'm going to do these straps up in a moment. So I'm just going to show you the other side. Okay, here we go. These are the breeze blocks that we got on from H&H. So those two there are strapped. That's double strapped because it's the first one on the top, which is then pushing down on the bottom ones as well. Strap, 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 strap. And then two on the back. So yeah, that's our load we've got to take to Christchurch, which is pretty much down near Bournemouth. Pretty much. Right, we are loaded, we are strapped, we are sweaty, and we are getting out of here. The vehicle coming to the left, let's let them past. Excellent. Okay. Oh yeah, so we're loaded, we're good to go, and this is going to go, where is it going? Christchurch, which is down sort of like near Portsmouth Way. I'm not entirely sure if I'm heading straight down there from here or going back to the yard. I kind of have to go, well I do have to go past Swindon to get there, but it's a little bit out of the way, not massively, like, I don't know, maybe only cost extra 20 minutes or so. It's about 3.5 hours to get from here to Swindon. 3.5 hours. And then it's about 2 hours in the morning. Maybe 2.5 hours to get to Bournemouth from the yard. So that's 5.5-6 hours total drive time. If I go straight there from here, it's about 5.5. So I think it's about 30 minutes difference. So, I don't know. I don't know. You'll find out in the next video, because I'm going to end this video here. So thank you very much for watching, do appreciate it. But I will be vlogging tomorrow, so stay tuned for the next video. We'll find out exactly what happened. Anyway, thanks for watching. Until next time, drive safe, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.